Guys, let's start with Donald Trump, because on his way to winning the Iowa primary, he found time to give Washington, D.C. a very lovely review.
We have a capital that we all love. Right now, it's a rat-infested, graffiti-infested shithole.
Yeah, I'm just impressed the rats can hold a spray can, to be honest. That Washington hole just happens to be celebrating its annual snowball fight, so let's see how bad D.C.'s really gotten.
This is what life is all about here, being with people, making new friends.
Coolest thing in the world.
It was 100% fun.
Media skills are like, whoa.
Like many major cities, it seems they have an ice problem too. And while analyzing Trump's big win, political cool pundit Dick Morris's interview on live TV was crashed by an underdressed intruder.
Dick Morris, your thoughts tonight?
Well, I think Trump is going to score a huge victory. I think the media is going to try to downplay it because, as you correctly said, they're basically supporting Ron. They're basically supporting Nikki Haley.
Whoa! There are almost two dicks in that shot. Being objective in journalism is vital. I would know, trust me. But this reporter took covering a boat show as a chance to share a truly unhinged personal opinion.
But we're going to show you everything from pontoon boats, which I didn't know didn't have bathrooms. Because in Puerto Rico, we're not pontoon boat people. They don't invite me to pontoon boat because the lake doesn't have a current, and everyone knows the pee-pee just stays in there. Oh. When you pee in the ocean, everyone knows the current takes it away.
That's right.
Lake, landlocked.
Wow.
It's pee-pee gets stuck.
Here's a tip. Don't go for a swim with her. Now, a cautionary tale for any pet owners out there.
As most dog owners know, sometimes they get into things. Some dog parents in Pittsburgh found that out the hard way when their dog ate $4,000 in cold, hard cash.
What?
The bank said it would replace any bills with visible serial numbers.
I was like, I'm just going to follow him and see if anything comes out for a couple of days. And
it did.
Oh, yeah.
My gosh.
Oh, you know that old excuse. The dog ate my house for payment. I reckon there's going to be a huge uptick in people checking dog poo at the park after this.
Wow.
Now, guys, it's been cold in the UK, and here's what happens when you let the public come up with the names for your snow clearing machines.
Minus 10. No wonder, then, that the gritters are out in lots of parts of the UK, and also the names of these gritters. They're a friend's tribute here.
Go on.
One of them's called Snowy Tribbiani.
Yeah, I like that. I've got Britney Spears.
I've got Sir David Attenborough.
That country used to rule the world. What happened? They also left out Chili Crystal and Whoopi Iceberg. Anyway, I'm no better, am I? Okay. Now, on live TV, it's easy to muddle your words, but somehow this weather presenter managed to call her co-host, Natalie, by the adorable name Channel Islands.
Sunshine, and here it will stay cold for a few days as well. Channel Islands. Sorry, Natalie.
Thank you very much. Lovely thing.
Now, it's an easy mistake to make. I get Sarah and Stradbroke Island mixed up all the time. What do you think about that, Rudy Hill? And finally, he didn't like it. That's what he thought about that. Finally, here is a chilling tale about the damage a storm can do.
A thunderous boom rattled Matt Houston awake inside his sister's home.
So we looked around and we were like, well, we don't see anything. Then I said, well, I'll go in the bathroom.
That's where he found the culprit.
I found this floating in the toilet.
Now, I've used some rough toilet paper in my life, but that is next level. You know, I wonder what Trump would think of that.
Shithole.
I worked on that for 15 minutes, thinking about how to get Trump back in there at the end. Guys, that was...
Let's talk.
We did it.